Captain Marcus Todd!
Yo, what's up? This is the Jay Dennis Podcast. What's up? What's up? This is the Jay Dennis Podcast. This is the part where I say the date. It's February 11th, 2020. I said it's February 11th, 2020 on a Tuesday. And the podcast goes something just like this.
Yeah! Goes a little something like this.
Yo, what's up? Yeah, so, as previously stated on the opening, it's Tuesday, February 11th, 2020. Welcome to the Jay Dennis Podcast, your top source for all things Jay Dennis, and by association, all things life. And not just insurance, but new metal, thrash metal, what the fuck am I up to doing, aside from speaking improperly? Listening to an iPod Nano that can barely hold a charge in the background. Because something about Papa Roach's love-hate tragedy is magical. There was just something innocent and simultaneously raunchy about the turn of the century. And that's on the alternative side of things. That's a era that I am trying to recreate and kind of like recapture and pay homage to.
For ticket or scan other media to continue, please touch, thank you, please enter.
So yeah, what's going on? These podcasts are getting a little bit longer again. You know why? Because I'm feeling good and I want to talk more. And I'm also pushing to see how long I can make these clips before they're too large to send. A lot of these clips have been coming out to 12 minutes, but lately they've been coming out to 13 and they still send okay. So, I don't know, man. We'll see. But, yeah, I don't know. Something has switched in me lately, and I think I can contribute it to definitely one thing, but then the second thing is, something I'm going to bring up after this sick bridge. So yeah, the thing I can definitely say that's definitely made life better the past 3-4 weeks has been having an income. Yeah, having money come in. A lot of the seeds that I planted late last year are starting to blossom into income. Able to pay bills, have a comma in my bank account, which I'd like to permanently keep there now. And I have several appointments coming up, many of which are qualified and more likely to hold because they're like second or third ones. And yeah, I've just been really aggressive with continually booking appointments and getting my 30 dials a day in. It's really difficult because while I'm doing my dials, I like to note what happened, whether it was a voicemail, no answer, contact, appointment, whatever. I like to log what I'm doing while I'm making the calls so I don't have to do it later, but it turns out it cuts the time in half when you just dial, and then I make a note on the side, and then I go back later and log it. I don't like doing it, but I get through the calls quicker if I do so, and I guess it feels less mentally taxing if I just focus on one thing. But sometimes there's dead time between waiting for the voicemail thing to come on, and I can, like, almost log the entire outcome, like, multitasking while I'm leaving the voicemail or whatever. But yeah, so the phone calls and the appointment setting have gotten a lot better, and those are two very important indicators to future success and income. I'm getting my squat back up, so the 5x5 is good. as you just heard at the beginning of the clip, a new Raptor Riot song is in the works. This is something I've been wanting to write for a while. I started, like, musing some lyric ideas, and then I pulled up an old document that I wrote probably like a year ago. I was like, shit, I already wrote lyrics to this song, but they need to be updated. They need to be moved around a little bit, because if I really want to do well at rapping, the dynamics have to match the music really well. Much like Jacoby Shaddix in this epic turn-of-the-century style rap that is clearly Caucasian. So yeah, not to slam Jacoby, because later on he actually gets better at rapping in, like, the Crooked Teeth album. But yeah, very turn of the century kind of corny style rapping there, where basic rhyme schemes are done. I want to build on that and make it more intense while capturing the energy of the turn of the century sound. And again, I'm not slamming Jacoby Shaddix and his rapping ability, but it's, I don't think it's his strongest ability, but he's got some pretty sick raps and rhymes in the Infest album. This is the She Loves Me, or the Love Hate Tragedy album that came out afterwards, and it's grossly underrated. It's a great album. So that song's coming along very well. Gonna be all sorts of type of vocal styles in that. It's gonna be a predominantly new metal alternative song. Like, you're gonna hear some, like, mid-2000s alternative influence in that, with, like, the fast drumming, the fast power chords. This guy's driving the wrong way. And, like, kind of like the higher-end guitar melody that sounds kind of... It sounds kind of punk alternative in a way. Like Rise Against. But anyway, what the fuck else is going on? The other thing I want to attribute it to, this good feeling that I've had lately, is something I've been doing since the beginning of February. I'm not doing it every day. I'm kind of doing it every other day, but at least today, this is my second day in a row doing it. I'm doing intermittent fasting. And aside from eating a little bit less, working out more, drinking more water, I think the intermittent fasting is doing a phenomenal job of helping me digest some of the bullshit, because I was taking in a lot of calories, a lot of unnecessary food. My grocery bill was getting really high. And I wasn't, like, training like a powerlifter or anything. So, like, I was always at a caloric surplus. So my energy would be low. And even though being hungry sucks and your energy gets kind of low and you kind of flatline, as soon as you eat something, especially some good complex carbs, it really spikes your energy up in such a great way. So I think because of the fact that my body is taking more time to digest... And not because your stomach's always working. When you intermittent fast, though, you give your intestinal tract, your GI, whatever, your stomach, you give all that shit a rest for a little while. And I think I've been able to work out some of the bullcrap that's been in my body for a while. And, you know, it's probably attributed to better gut health. And my gut has actually gone down. Like, I'm getting pretty slim now. And but slim, what if you win? Wouldn't that be weird? Why? So you could just lie just to get me here and sit me here next to Christina Aguilera and Carson Daly and Fred Durst and hear them argue over who she gave head to first. Ah! Little bitch will be on blast on MTV. That is cute, though, but I think he likes Jay-Z. I should download the audio to MP3 and show the world how I gave him an MVD. Ah! I know I got, like, half of that wrong, so fuck you. That's how my brain works. If I make a song reference, or if I hear... If I say a word that's in a song or a lyric, my brain does that. I think in terms of music. That's my language. I think in terms of music. But yeah, no, my energy's just through the goddamn roof right now. And, like, I'm getting shit done. And again, some switches have flipped. And, like, my desire to get up early every day has gone up. Like, last night I forgot to set a couple of alarms. But I still woke up early this morning. I got up at 5:30. There's this bullshit wine that I bought that I think is like making me a little bit sleepier, and it's kind of giving me a little bit of a wine hangover, even though I'm not getting drunk on it. But whenever I drink that the night before, like on a Monday night watching The Bachelor with my wife, I usually sleep a little bit later. So I probably would have been up at 4:30 this morning without the alarm, because I woke up, but like my head was just fucking spinning, and not like a tired spinning, but like a headache spinning. I'm like, shit, I need to rest a little more and get my 7 hours, because I went to bed at 10:30. So yeah, no, getting up early consistently has been easier. My desire to push through phone calls and talk to people and talk to strangers and just do everything in general has been better. And again, the creative juices are flowing with Raptor Riot. I got a couple songs in the work, in the works. And as I continue to chisel away at this debt, get my income up, I will be getting back into the studio and putting in more music, because I'm basically like feeling at least as excited as I did than like back in 2016 when I was recording the Sabotage EP, which that was a chunk of music. Like, I've actually left behind some sort of legacy. It's online, but I have music. Like, I have music up, and it's like an EP that I'm proud of. So I want to build on that, start playing in front of people, and help people do well at life financially, and lead a goddamn revolutionary movement. And the last thing I'll talk about is part of what's inspired a lot of this is, aside from feeling better, I did recently finish the Mustaine audiobook, which is a book about Dave Mustaine's life. It pretty much went all the way up to the System Has Failed album. Actually, no, I think he talked a little bit about... I think the book came out in 2012, so he probably talked up until about Endgame. And just, you know, just hearing about the rock star life, and not the drugs part, but just hearing about the rock star life and just feeling good about the art you've created and being able to share it with the world, like, it gets me crazy. And like hearing the stories and hearing a very authentic person talk about their art and their expression of it really just makes me want to do it more. So with that being said, here's some Black Clouds. That's the alternative sound I'm talking about. Yo, what's up? This is the J. Dennis Podcast. Yo, it's Thursday, February 6th, 2020, and... And whenever I get down on myself, which isn't too often, I have to remember something. I have a small catalog of music that I've recorded back in the 2010s. And I have a bunch of videos up on YouTube. And even though Raptor Riot isn't insanely popular, or my YouTube channel at this time only has 111 subscribers, I do have a legacy. So, and I have created stuff to be proud of. I may have mentioned on the last podcast that I couldn't find the charger I'd used for my iPod Nano. It broke, and I'm like, shit, I can't charge my iPod and listen to it, because even though I could listen to it on my my other laptop, my music and my Raptor Riot EP, you know, aside from going to YouTube, I was like, shit, how am I gonna get to it without using the internet or YouTube, where the sound quality's not as good? Well, I went down to the basement, and I immediately saw a extra power cord that I have, or a charging cord. And I charged it, and now here we are. What a time. You're trying to stop, but you can't back up. You play around, paying heavy with the rent to cut back. Small load of a million. That song is on my YouTube channel. It's called Broke Ass. It's the most recent Raptor Riot song I did. I'm going to play one more part from you, or from it, and to continue with the clip. I got really fucking aggressive on this song. So, basically with that song, I channeled a lot of my biggest influences onto that particular track. At the end there, you can tell I'm heavily influenced by Limp Bizkit, but with regard to that last part that you heard, and even the guy that I was recording with when I was doing vocals, acknowledged this. He's like, dude, the way you've layered the final chorus and like the outro, because I like big outros. I like to have a nice strong ending to a song. And he said you're doing like some Sum 41 Chuck stuff. And I'm like, yes, you know. And he's like, so based on that, I know what effects to use. And I'm like, yes. So like, you know, you hear the screaming. But then on the top layer, you hear kind of like a walkie-talkie effect on the background chorus being repeated. So, Broke Ass in a lot of ways is a perfect culmination, lyrically and mostly musically, of my nu metal and alternative influences. And of course, it's got a little bit of a nu metalcore flavor in there too, but it's mostly a nu metal track, as it should be. Motherfucker, what are you doing? Fucking jaywalkers, man. Only I can jaywalk. But no, I'm feeling really good. Again, getting back on Guitar Pro more frequently. Writing music, kind of reviving some shit. Not that it ever died, it's just my attention was elsewhere. But the way I've structured my day... Hold on, motherfucker.
Please touch screen for ticket or scan other media to continue. Thank you. Please enter.
The way I've structured my day, being able to set aside some time. Basically, I maximize the time that I have with myself. Because when my wife is around, I want to be present with her. And just because she's home or something doesn't mean I can't do my own stuff. But I don't want to just be in my own world the entire time. I'd like to be able to focus on her as much as I can and be a good husband. But there are hours of the day, early in the morning, and otherwise, I don't have as many outside commitments as she does. So there's a lot of times where I'm home alone and she's out doing something. And I use that time, if I'm wise, I use that time to... spend time writing music or reflecting or habit building, everything like that. Oh shit, listen to this. So, when I listen to some of this older stuff that I wrote back in, like, 2012, it's very, very clear that if you were one of the 10-odd people that were a fan of my old high school and part of college band, you can fucking hear me, obviously, because I wrote the music, and I've explained this in videos and past podcasts, of course, my drummer... wrote his parts, and then vocalist wrote, you know, the lyrics and, you know, hooks and everything. But like writing the music and like the melodies and the rhythm, like you can hear my shit. So like if anybody that was ever a fan of my old band listened to my solo shit, they'd be like, oh shit, with regard to what was written in the band's music, I can definitely hear the J flavor, because the majority of it was my flavor. I'm not bringing this up to say, like, I didn't get credit or anything. It's just to say that my style has always kind of existed the way it has. I've always been big on powerful openings, powerful closings, and not that the middle has to be shit or anything, but I like solos that end on a big harmony. I like outros that lead on a or end on a powerful vocal note. You know, I'm trying to be a little diverse in my writing style, but I just like my songs to have an impact. Like, I don't want any filler crap on the album. And as you heard on the Broke-Ass track at the end where I say, since 1999, that's the name of the fucking Raptor Riot album. Okay? That's the name of the Raptor Riot album. And I know I've said it before, but I'm going to say it again. That's my album title. That's my brand. Since 1999, that's my brand. And it's not because I was born in 1999, it's because that's the era that shaped me, and that's the era that I'm looking to not replicate, because it's already happened. You know, the new metal wave that's already happened is come and gone, like, and the whole boom about the millennium happened because it already happened 20 years ago. Like, I think all that stuff's already happened, but I know that there's a market, especially in my generation and past generations too. Don't act like you boomers and you Gen Xers didn't get horny when a lot of the 80s and even some of the 90s stuff made its way back around, because it has. But I know with my generation, especially with social media making it so easily accessible, and YouTube, you're able to find a bunch of old footage and everything. There's a huge market for it. So yeah, that's my brand. My music is active and building on that. And I'm feeling really good. I've had a really good week. This is the 9th day in a row that I've woken up on the first alarm. When I do it tomorrow on Friday morning, I'll have done it every weekday. Woken up when I was supposed to. And I've just had a really productive couple of weeks, and it's been really good. Money-wise, spiritually, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm wearing a black suit right now. As soon as I started getting paid in my career, I bought a couple of new suits. One was gray and one was navy, and they fit me better versus the black suit that I bought back in 2016 when I was in college. A comfortable suit jacket for me is a 44 regular. This black jacket I'm wearing right now is a 46 large, but back when I bought this jacket, I was larger. I had bigger muscles. I was broader. I wasn't a bodybuilder or anything, but I was bigger. I was 210 pounds, and now I've been hovering around 185 the past couple of years, or at least since I've moved here, in a sense. But since I've started benching and doing my 5x5 again, my size is going back up, so I want to fit back into this pretty well and be able to actually rotate through my damn suits instead of wearing them out so quickly. Anyway, here's We're Made. You through your ass, don't know how much gas has passed. Oh my god, it feels like I'm dying. No one ever told me when the fecal smells so bad, is steaming all alone inside the bowl. Oh my god. Yo, what's up? It's Friday, February 7th, 2020. It's about 3 o'clock. Let me just tell you something, guys. Working in the financial services, whether you're an advisor, an insurance, life insurance agent, whatever, it's fantastic, but you better damn make sure you got all your I's dotted and your T's crossed, because depending on what you're selling or recommending, the hoops you have to jump through to get through red tape and back office crap can be quite annoying. Now, this particular instance, I'm not going to bitch about and say, was annoying, because it worked out. As soon as I needed the thing, it got done. I appreciate the client being readily available for me to do that. But yeah, one little piece of information was missing. And yeah, like, when you have to get a signature to validate some kind of like secondary information, not like anything super serious, but like just like contact information or whatever, to get a signature on something, it's a pain in the ass. You can't just call the back office and say, oh yeah, here's the information you're seeking. So yeah, no, I just had to go retrieve a signature. Fortunately, it worked out, but you know, that's why I get paid the big bucks when things work out, because provided I'm available, which luckily I've had some downtime this week where I was able to act on the spot with certain requests. Yeah, at the drop of a hat, you got to be ready to do something. Especially when there's like money on the line and there's case preparation on the line. They're like, we need this in a week or it's going to get canceled. It's like, what the fuck? But anyway, this was a very productive day. Very productive week, rather. I booked 10 appointments, which is a perfect week. Day's not over yet, and tomorrow's not over, so I could get a surplus by the end of the week. But I've at least got the 10, which is the lead indicator for my my number one goal in my 12-week year, which is to achieve a certain amount of income per month. I started writing a song. This song's been in the works for about a year and a half now. But in terms of writing it on Guitar Pro and putting some lyrics together, I started that this morning. Spent 30 minutes on it. If I do 75 minutes a week, which is 15 minutes a day for 5 days, then to me that's a solid week. Because if it's all about consistency, you know, I spend that at least an hour a week doing it, then by summertime, I'll have a handful of songs that I can practice vocals to and everything that I've written. But the song's called Gaslight. It's probably going to be my favorite song I've ever written. It just really needs to be written right, but I got a good amount of the actual song written. I just need to work on the drums, guitar riffs, verses, chorus, bridge. I got all that written. I just need to kind of maybe write an outro. Lyrics, I've got, you know, a couple of ideas. I think I got a chorus. I just love that the creative juices are flowing again. You know, it feels good. And, yeah, consistency is key. I need to go to the gym today to at least get 2 out of the 3 required days I need for powerlifting. This week was pretty bad. I went Monday, but I haven't been since. Sometimes the day just gets away from you, and that's a bad excuse, but I don't know. But my prospecting has been good. What else? What else is up? What the fuck else happened? Like, I wrote some new business this week, which is good. I had some good appointments. I booked the 10. Fucking Iowa. Fucking Booty Edge, thinking he can do a victory lap prematurely. Can't stand that guy. Cannot stand him. Bernie won. Bernie's going to keep winning. It's going to be fan-fucking-tastic because he has the best shot of absolutely obliterating that douche that we currently have sitting in the Oval Office. That douche, that turd, needs to be flushed. And I'm not going to say, the next election's going to be a contest between a douche and a turd. It's like, no, when Bernie Sanders is the nominee. And here's the thing, if you don't like Bernie, then you don't like what most of the country wants. And, you know, doing what's popular doesn't always mean you're doing what's right. But Trump won on a fake populist campaign. He thought he was doing what everybody wanted. But no, none of his policies or his ideas are supported by the majority of Americans. Universal healthcare, free college, affordable housing, Social Security, Medicare. Universal healthcare, if I didn't already say it. All that shit is supported by the majority of Americans, as well as universal background checks on guns. Majority of Americans support all those things. Bernie's a true populist. And to think you can just say the word socialist and that's going to make everybody shrivel up and think it's a bad thing, it's like, no. It's coming from a place of ignorance and misunderstanding. So, yeah, because we're currently heading in the direction of fascism right now, where the press is being silenced, even though the press is predominantly corporate bullshit that only cares about ratings and profits over actual journalism. So, you know, the press maybe does deserve to be attacked a little bit, but there's still the press. We still have the right to choose who we want to watch and who we want to listen to. And a lot of this corporate press is basically a propaganda machine, but it's still under attack. And there shouldn't be threats or bombs or anything sent to particular places, or any for that matter. Violence is not the answer, and it's done by these radical right-wing domestic terrorists. All the terrorism that's happened in our country as of late has happened from right-wing extreme ideologues. They're fucked up. They are empowered by the current douche that's sitting in the Oval Office. I refuse to call him the president because he is not a president. He is not presidential. He's not a leader. He fucking sucks. All he cares about is himself and enriching himself. And he should have been impeached over emoluments because he never divested from his business. He's having the Secret Service pay for basically all the money that's the Secret Service is paying to stay at his resorts while they're protecting him and his stupid family. It's going back into the pockets of his family. He's enriching himself. He's using the power of the office to enrich himself, to pass tax cuts that can help him preserve his bullshit wealth. So anyway, yeah, I've had a productive week. I'm going to finish off the day and tomorrow with some good gym time by putting in more time into Gaslight and finishing off another song. I'll probably tease something in this clip, or you may have already heard something by now. But again, this music, especially Gaslight, is heavily, heavily influenced by nu metal and alternative. Like, Raptor Riot is an amalgamation of nu metal music, alternative music, a little bit of metalcore. But when you hear Raptor Riot, mostly think turn of the century nu metal music, nu metal. Like, the main genre is nu metal, and then like the secondary ones are like alternative, like Sum 41, or I don't know, fucking The Used, I don't know, Sum 41. And then yeah, of course metalcore as well. So anyway, I'm gonna go to the gym. I know there was other shit I wanted to talk about, but again, it was a good week. I wrote some business, should have some more money coming in. Like, I kind of have, I'm not getting cocky or anything, because if something falls through, it's still like a big deal, because it's like I don't have a massive pipeline full of stuff right now, but like, I have a lot of legitimate follow-up activity and future appointment preparation that I need to do, and like, it's a good problem to have to be like actually like busy. It's difficult though. It's difficult to stay on top of your follow-up calls and your prospecting whilst maintaining current tasks and current opportunity things you have to do, especially with some of the practices I've been implementing with regards to like sending people meeting summaries or recaps, sending them information ahead of time, basically keeping the communication open during the downtime so that the interest or the fire doesn't die out. That's a very difficult part of the business, is you have a meeting with somebody. It's, you know, kind of like when you have a date, you know, you feel like there's something hot there in the moment, but like then you never follow up and you come back a month later or you find out the date has to reschedule the next day. Like, oh, I can't make it out tonight. And then a month passes by, things fizzle. And then you end up not being able to reconnect, or if the person is immature enough, it just becomes awkward. So I believe my communication skills and my ability to sell have gotten way better, and I'm actually running my business like a business. You know, I still got a long way to go before I reach some level of consistent comfort, but I'm moving towards it, taking this shit one day at a time, and having a good day. What's up? It's Saturday, the 8th of February, 2020. It's about noon o'clock. And I've had a filthy car on the exterior for the past couple of months. Because, you know, during the winter months, it's kind of redundant to wash your car, and the water here is ice cold in the winter, so like it isn't feasible, and I don't have the disposable income right now to just willy-nilly go to a car wash. But at this point, I'm tired of it. I'm tired of having a dirty car, so I actually don't have any soap, so I'm running up to Walmart to get some, as well as a few other things. I know I've ripped on Walmart in the past, and I'm still not a big fan of it, but it seems like they're somewhat trying to turn their image around a little bit, and at least the ones out here aren't as bad as the ones that I went to, like, in certain parts of Central Florida. So, I mean, it's like, whatever. Sometimes you just... You go to where is... You can have principles and, you know, stand by it for sure. Other times... You go to what's nearby, or really no other store sells what you're looking for except for Walmart, so it sucks. But anyway, I spent a good amount of time. Ooh, hold on. New metal. Yeah, a little 2014 action there for you. That particular song, Kids These Days, is going to be just a tidbit reimagined for a future Raptor Riot track. It's still going to be called Kids These Days, though. So yeah, I spent a good amount of time this morning and this week overall. I exceeded 75 minutes, more like an hour and a half at this point, maybe almost 2 hours, working on Gaslight. So sometimes I will just lay down the entire skeleton of a song if I have it all written. But with Gaslight, I'm kind of transposing everything all at once for each section. So for like, instead of laying out all the guitars for the entire song and then layering stuff on top of it piece by piece, I'm, right now at least, it's, the first, like, 40 seconds of the song, every instrument is laid down, and I'm not an engineer by any means, but I try to mix it and somewhat master it as well as I can, because it's all digital, to make it to where you can hear everything, everything sounds good, and I can effectively practice vocals and lyrics to it. So, it'll be better once I have it playing through my actual speakers rather than my shitty, broken laptop speakers, because this laptop's from like 2012. I mean, it's a good brand, it's lasted all these years, but like, still just trying to get the most out of it. And I only use it to record music on now. I pretty much use my work laptop for everything else now. But yeah, so that's what I was doing. And before that, I ran over to a post office box or a mail, one of those blue mailboxes that are like in public locations, because the way my mailbox in my house is designed, it's hard to send outgoing mail out of it, which is annoying. Because it's the mailbox is built into the wall, and there's a chute that goes down into a box into my garage where I get it. So to actually send outbound mail is kind of difficult. But fortunately, I live right next to a grocery store that I can walk to that has a mailbox that you can send outbound mail to. So I still occasionally get mail from people that I never asked to get mail from. So I either call the customer service line or something and ask them to take me off of it, or I have to send some sort of troll letter, like what I just did this morning. I sent two, actually. One of them wasn't a troll letter, because they only send something to me like once every 2 months, but it's like I don't like getting mail. I don't like getting mail because it's clutter. Like, if it's a bill for like my car insurance, okay, I end up paying it online anyway. The bill just serves as a physical reminder that I need to pay something. Like, I don't mind bills, even though bills fucking suck. But anything else, really, I don't want. Which is why I took myself off of credit pre-screen offers, so I don't get stupid credit card offers anymore. I don't get stupid balance transfer offers anymore because I don't have a balance. And yeah, with regards to political campaigns, the only one I've been getting is just a shit ton of Tom Steyer mailers. Now again, I don't necessarily disagree with what he stands for the most part, but like he's by no means my first choice. So yeah, like if something was being sent like once a week or once every 2 weeks, like, you know, Bernie or Elizabeth Warren, you know, it probably wouldn't bother me so much. But with Tom Steyer, the shit comes like at least every other day. It's obnoxious. And, like, with ads and shit, like, whatever. Like, the ads don't really bother me too much, or the billboards, but, like, just the incessant mailers irritates me. So I ripped it to shreds, stuffed it in an envelope, found the P.O. box number on the mailer that needed to be sent to, and I just put, "Enough! Take me off your mailing list," and I put my address. Like, just stop. So I'll probably get plenty more before they process it, because anytime you call or do that, they're like, "It takes 4 to 6 weeks to process, and, you know, anything that's sent out between now and then was out of our control." So whatever, but, you know, makes for a pretty damn good story. Like, this is probably the best story you've heard all week, and it'll make for an interesting story for whoever ends up receiving that and opening it and processing it. Like, I love being somebody's story of the day. Like, oh my god, this weird guy drove past me and shouted something about Fred Durst and cucumbers. I don't know. I like being the interesting part of somebody's day, because my life is interesting, which is why I podcast about it and why millions of you are just hooked onto my every word. But anyway, now that I got some money in the bank and I got a little extra money in the bank and I'm getting back on top of things, there are some essentials I've been putting off, which sucks because I tend to make stuff last, but sometimes I end up making shit last too long and it just doesn't look good, and I'm like, I need to discard some of these old, younger habits and mindsets of mine that aren't relevant anymore. So that being said, I need new clothes. I need a new belt, I need some new dress shirts, need some new underpants, boxer briefs, maybe some socks. I made a list. So I'm going to the best place to buy all those things. Costco. I really do need a new black suit jacket, though. So I'm probably going to go to Burlington for that. But that's my exciting Saturday. I've already meditated today. I've already exceeded the amount of time my my minimum commitment on Guitar Pro this week, but I'm feeling, again, I'm feeling creative, so I feel like I have a pretty damn good capture of how I want this song to go. It feels really good because I really feel like I found my voice, you know, back in like 2014, 2015, 2016, like with, you know, Raptor Riot and the Sabotage EP. And what else? Even though my ass is sore as hell from yesterday doing squats, and I need to go harder on the bench, but my bench is still improving. I haven't maxed out beyond my current amount yet, and I can still only put up 185 two times. If I had a spotter, I could probably do it a few more times, but you know, it's still improvement. Got a big hefty goal ahead of me if I want to put up 205 this month. But I'm going to go to the gym today, do some upper body, do some abs, do some cardio, just to finish off the week strong. Go to Costco, go to fucking Walmart, which I'm at right now. Wash my cars, including my wife's car. And here's the old version of the HCL. Wait, hold on, no. That's the first course. I want you to hear the last part. The HCL on the Sabotage EP, which you can get at raptorriot.bandcamp.com, is recorded in drop C and it features more rapping and more singing. This older version is heavier, has more screaming and singing. I was trying to do like that Attila style, like fast screaming. But yeah, gonna end up the week strong. And thank you guys for listening. Here's some old school pre-Raptor Riot Jay Dennis, the HCL. Yo, what's up? It's Sunday, February 9th, 2020. And it's kind of funny how impressionable my brain is with regard to music. Or just seeing stuff or hearing things, and it makes me want to listen to or binge on an entire artist's discography. I've probably talked about this lately, and I've disclosed it to my wife a couple times, but when I was at church today, I'll give you an example. When I was at church today, not that the guy playing the guitar is by any means a rock star looking person, but just seeing them playing in the type of, Fender Telecaster they were playing, for some odd reason, it made me think of Corey Taylor playing like Hydrograd songs live. And I guess there are songs that he plays live guitar on. You know, he's a frontman vocalist, but I guess he plays guitar sometimes. So just seeing that made me want to listen to the Stone Sour discography. And as you've heard on previous clips and recent podcasts, I've had some Stone Sour playing already. But now my desire to go back and listen to Hydrograd, House of Bones Part 1 and 2, and Audio Secrecy. They have 6 albums total, I think. They have Self-Titled, came out in 2002. Then they have Come Whatever May, which is playing right now. Then they have Audio Secrecy, and then House of Bones Part 1, then Part 2, that's 5. And then, Hydrograd. They have 6 albums. So I don't know, man. Maybe that'll be the next band that I do ranking. That I rank on YouTube. I don't know. Why the fuck are we ranking artists? Like, why are we ranking albums? I'm just sharing my opinions and my thoughts on them. I'm not actually a bona fide critic. Okay, I'm not judging an artist. Like, music is totally subjective. And while you can look at some things objectively and, you know, state that there's a certain level of talent or What's that fucking word? Affinity. Aptitude. Whatever. There. Like, even if I don't like country music at all, I can say with plenty of confidence there's plenty of country artists that have significantly more talent than some of these mumble rap artists or something. Granted, I don't like either of those genres. But, anyway, it's about 7:30 at night. I just left the gym. It was one of those, like, wasn't really feeling it sessions, but I still went anyway. Because, you know, like, all the successful people say, they're like, oh, yeah, the successful people, they do stuff even when they don't feel like it. Doesn't mean that while you're doing the thing, it still doesn't feel good. And, like, you don't get amped up. Because there's plenty of times where I go to the gym, and I feel awesome. And no, it's not fucking beast mode. Like, it's... I feel awesome. But then there's times where it's like I'm literally going through the motions. But it's like, whatever, man. It's probably more beneficial that I'm doing this instead of sitting on the couch watching BoJack Horseman, which I do need to do, watch season 6, and drinking a mixed drink of LaCroix and shitty Cab Sauvignon. There's this bad bottle of Cab Sauvignon I bought, because I don't like buying expensive wine. I bought like a $7 bottle, and by itself it's like okay, but I was like, what would this taste like if I mixed in some Spindrift, which is another kind of soda water that's flavored with fruit, or LaCroix? And while it doesn't taste terrible, for some odd reason it like always gives me a headache, like a fucking sugar hangover or something, even though there's really no sugar involved. It just hasn't been feeling that good. But yeah, so this last week was pretty damn successful on some fronts. I booked 10 appointments, so that's the leading indicator for goal number one. Did that, but with like dials and points, I got like a high D on those. I think I got like a C, like a 72% of dials made. But hey, whatever, man. The leading one is the one that counts. But whatever, man. You still got to be consistent with all of them, because just because you hit the bare minimum doesn't mean you should be coasting. Then with the gym and running a mile, just kind of scraped by on that one. I went a couple of times, but not enough to have a perfect week. But the one I really shined on, and again, where you're really hearing it on this podcast, was instead of spending 75 minutes on a new song for Raptor Riot, I spent about probably about 2 hours. So that's 120 minutes. So got like a nice little 133% surplus. And don't fucking do the math, okay? Like that's what I remember. It's probably a variation, but it felt like about 2 hours. I usually look at the time and see what time it is when I start. And, you know, try to, like, hyper-focus on just doing the thing. Oh, by the way, this song right here.
Did you really think I wouldn't see this through?
ZZYZX Road.
Tell me I should stay.
Definitely one of the best songs I've ever heard in my life. Like, still one of my favorites. Great closing track. Come on, you dumbass password. I have to let my wife know when I'm heading home, because she's like sitting down with the dog, my little French bulldog. Or, like, laying in bed with him because she's not feeling well. He, like, loses his shit when I open the garage door. Like, I know over time, both my German Shepherd and my French Bulldog will become more dignified. And not, like, act like crazy puppies, because Hercules is coming on about 3 years old here soon. And I love his puppy energy. They're both excellent dogs. Like, I couldn't picture my life without them. They're both amazing animals, as are my cats. Oh yeah, if I open the garage door and there was like no heads up, he loses his shit and he gets up and he's a little fucking ball of muscle. My French bulldog, he's a fucking ball of muscle. So when he gets up hard and fast, he like presses down, potentially crushing my wife's tummy or sternum or something. Can't be doing that. So yeah, past couple weeks have been very successful. Like, I always have to see the silver lining and stuff, because even if there are shortcomings, like, yeah, actually not perfect. Even if there are shortcomings, I see, like, great areas of improvement in other areas. Like, the fact that I've spent the past 2 weeks, waking up early and on time, like, that's unheard of. That's unheard of! Like this monster guitar solo. It's just a great closing track. And a little piece of my sophomore year of high school. Like I said, man, I've always wished I was part of, like, Generation X. Having come of age during, like, the early 90s and at least being old enough to go to, like, some concerts in the 80s or something. But mostly the 90s. But, I came up during a great time. So, I mean, whatever. There's only so much control you can have. And I can always go back and listen to this shit. And, this book that I'm rereading that I read, like, a long time ago. Back in 2013. Which is considered a long time ago now. Book that I read a long time ago called The Productive Narcissist. I have a change the world mentality, apparently. And narcissism, or a narcissistic personality, which a couple of, you know, well-known people that have it, which, you know, you say what you want about some of these people, but they did change the world, and some of them for the better. Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, Oprah Winfrey. I know there were a couple of, Martha Stewart, like, you know, just a couple people right there. You can like them, you can not, whatever. They still did incredible things. But yeah, the whole change the world mentality. Like, it's not just good enough for me to want to play on stage in front of thousands of people. I want to fucking change the world. I want to create an anti-revolution or a counterculture movement against this bullshit status quo that we have right now. Where people are just complacent and content. And fortunately, my generation isn't buying the bullshit that much more. Like, the old guard is starting to die out. A lot of these old ways of doing things are starting to die out. And, you know, just listening to the corporate media for what it's worth and just thinking, oh, I have to have a credit score and contribute to the economy and be a consumer. That's the way it's done. Like, no, it's not. It's not how it's done anymore. And, like, you know, oh, yep, you work at the same job for 60 years, you get a pension, there's no fucking pensions anymore. And then you get a silver watch and you retire for 10 years. Retirement lasts for decades now. I want to create a counterculture movement and just lead by example in the best way possible and let people know that social media is destroying our culture. Smartphone addiction is destroying our culture. It's destroying our species. And I'm no better with regards to my own personal smartphone addiction. You know, the majority of it is, you know, auditory, like me just listening to an iPod or if I was back in the 80s or the 90s, a tape deck. Like, that's what I would have been 20 odd years ago. The guy who was always had his headphones in. And that's how I was back in high school. I always had my headphones in with my iPod or my PSP or whatever. But, you know, a little bit of screen addiction is there. You know, watching YouTube a lot kind of supplements instead of playing video games or watching TV. Like, smartphones have become the new TV. But it's fucking stupid, and it's destroying our necks, and it's destroying our ability to communicate with each other. And I want to change the world and lead by example. And the Productive Narcissist book, I'm going to talk about it more, probably on the next clip. But I read it a while back. I felt like reading it again. There's different personality types. I'm talking about the personality type, not the disorder. Narcissists have just this really intense power that comes from within. And that's where all of their meaning and everything is derived from. So here's Stone Sour 30-31-50, which I think is about his waist size, his jean length, like his, like 30-30 is his jean length, and 150 is his weight. Would have never guessed that back in 2006. Yo, what's up? It's still Tuesday, February 11th, 2020. So, if you've listened to this whole podcast so far, we've come full circle. We opened up with, you know, the day that the podcast is up, and then we close out with it actually being Tuesday. Because occasionally I'll record two clips in one day for Tuesday, so I guess this is how I'll do it, because I don't want to have to rename all the other clips and put, you know, since they're all different clips, I put like part one, part two, part three, part four when I upload them. I don't have to move them all up apart just so that this one can come right after the first one. Does that make sense? Okay, great. So, I just had some fun. I took, hold on a second. You ever just take a shopping cart for a ride? You know, when you run down the aisle on a shopping cart and you jump on it and you ride it and you run on it. Well, I just did that downhill in a parking lot and it was fucking fun. It made me happy and I just wanted to share that with you. But also there were a couple of topics I forgot to touch on at the top of the podcast. One of those being, I think a big reason why I've been feeling so good lately is because my car's finally clean. I washed all the bullshit of last year off of my vehicle. You know, it's kind of hard to keep your car clean out here unless you constantly go to a car wash or something, which I don't have the disposable income to do that. I prefer to wash it myself, even though it is a little bit time consuming. It was just warm enough over the weekend to where I finally washed my wife and I's cars, and I buy the tire shine spray too, so when your tires are clean, looking and shiny also, including the rubber, the whole car just looks fucking phenomenal. And what was happening was along the bottom of the trunk, I'd have to always find a place where my fingers had already been that wasn't dirty. Because when your whole car is dirty, the part of the trunk that you close has a bunch of dirt and grime on it. So you just look for that one spot that you've already wiped off with your hand. But it's like, nope, no, I don't have to worry about that, because the whole damn car is clean and shiny now, and it was worth it. I was listening and finishing up the Dave Mustaine book while I was doing it, and now here I am listening to Megadeth again a whole bunch. And that's another thing I want to talk about, this amazing-ass tour. There's like three really good concerts, well, mostly one or two. The third one's kind of just a bonus, but a major tour was just announced featuring three bands that I've binged on, and then I guess you could say Trivium was one of the first bands I binged on with Spotify when I moved out here. But the way I've been binge listening to these other bands is a whole different level, and the fact that they're all touring together and they're going to come here to my town later this year, I have to go to this concert. You want to know what the lineup is if you haven't already seen it? It's fucking In Flames, which is just amazing. I cannot wait to see them. Followed by Trivium. So already right there, two bands that I really want to see live, especially Trivium. I think I've only seen Trivium once. I want to see them again, because they're one of those bands that doesn't put out live albums. Lamb of God. Another band that, you know, I probably could have saw back in high school but didn't. Apparently one of the greatest live bands ever. And then the headliner, the Big Daddy, fucking Megadeth. That is a monster lineup. No filler, no bullshit. Four bands that I love. Ugh. An 80s and 90s thrash metal legend. There's a lot of bands that I haven't got the chance to see, or that I probably never will see because they've retired. like Slayer. When does Metallica ever roll through here? Like, there's certain bands that I'm probably never going to get to see because they either don't tour out here or they're done. When I make it to this concert, there will pretty much only be one major band left for me to see that I haven't seen yet, and that's Limp Bizkit. Because I've seen Linkin Park, saw them before Chester passed away. I need to see Papa Roach. But I think in like 2 months from now, Korn and Breaking Benjamin are coming, and I really want to see Breaking Benjamin. But of course, Korn is one of my favorite bands, and I'd love to see them a third time. Because they're just monsters right now. And then later this year, this is the bonus concert that I would just love to go to, but really mostly to see only one band. It's Gojira, and Poppy, whoever the hell they are. And who's headlining that one? Deftones. That's a band that I would like to see very much live. I would like to see them live. I'm kind of curious what they sound like live. I don't know how much different they are back then than they are now, but I'm pretty sure they still put on a hell of a show. So this could very well be, once again, the year of concerts for me. I've only been to 2 concerts since I moved out here, and one of them was a bust because Crazy Town didn't show up. But last year I saw Seven Dust, and that was amazing. So yeah, fucking Megadeth, man. They're coming out to my neck of the woods later this year with In Flames, who still sound amazing live. Trivium, same story. And probably, yeah, Lamb of God. Just 4 monsters. Absolutely. I'll pay whatever price to see that. I hate when people do that, you fucking idiot. Anyway, so yeah, thank you guys for listening to this podcast. All the old episodes are up on my YouTube channel, which you're currently on probably. The podcast has its own playlist within the channel, the Jay Dennis Podcast. I've been doing this for about 4 years now, pretty damn consistently. Eventually, this will be up on other platforms, but I'm not too worried about that right now because this isn't my main joint. But you know, subscribe to the channel. YouTube is probably the only thing I'm doing right now. I really don't do social media at all anymore. I haven't posted anything at all this year, this decade. Really don't care. If you want to support the podcast and support me, go to raptorriot.bandcamp.com and download the Sabotage EP. You know, the more money I get from that, the more I can put into recording the album. Otherwise, it's all just totally self-funded. But yeah, that's what's up. Go check out all my other videos. Go check out Raptor Riot. Go check out the Jay Dennis demos. Everything's on my channel. I don't care if it's not congruent with the YouTube algorithm. Like, fuck it. I'm not going to make 7 different channels to cater to that shit. All right? Thanks for listening. Love you guys. And catch you on the next podcast.